You know, if I were to describe the book, it's a rehumanization effort because, you know, for me, a black woman from a working class background to have the opportunity to tell her story is interestingly rare. You know, I think that's why some people ask the question, how did you become here? How did you go from here to there? It's sort of like people think I'm a unicorn. It's like I don't exist. Like people like me don't exist. And I know that there are so many people in this country, in this world, who feel like they don't exist because their stories aren't told, or they think their stories aren't worthy of being told. You know, in this country, we've gotten to the point where we kind of think that there's only a handful of legitimate stories that make you a true American. And so if you don't fall into that narrow sort of line, it's like you don't belong. But we all belong. And I think my book is just, it's the ordinariness of a very extraordinary story. And I hope that by telling it, that it makes others, not just black women, not just black people, but other people, other women, people who feel faceless and invisible and voiceless, to feel the pride in their story in the way that I feel about mine. The ordinariness of growing up as a working class kid with two parents who had values, they didn't have a lot of money. You know, we grew up with music and art and love, and that was just about it. And we were encouraged to get an education. You know, I am not a unicorn. There are millions of kids like me out there. And it's just a shame that sometimes people will see me and they will only see my color. And then they'll make certain judgments about that. And that's dangerous for us to dehumanize each other in that way. We are all just people, you know, with stories to tell. And we're flawed and broken, and there's no miracle in our stories. It's just we're living life trying to do good. And that's who this little girl in Becoming is. She is becoming a lot of things in life, but the journey continues. And I hope that it starts a conversation about voice, and it encourages so many other people, because we need to know everyone's stories so that we don't forget the humanity in each other. Because what we've learned, Barack and I, over the course of this 8 years and traveling around the country, is that Americans are good people, decent people, really, even if we don't agree on politics. And we have to remember that about ourselves and understand that that's true not just here in America, but around the world. There are no devils out there. There are no people out there. There are people who do bad things, but all of us are really just trying to figure it out. And if we've done something really horrible, it's usually because we were broken in some way. And if we understand each other's stories and we share those stories, that maybe we can be more empathetic. Maybe we can be more inclusive. Maybe we can be more forgiving and be more open. So I hope that the book encourages some conversation around those kind of things. And then you'll hear about the China and my shoes. A couple of nice stories, you know. Bo and Sunny make an appearance, so not to worry. They're there. They're still alive, doing well, by the way.
Thank you.